Snow is the most critical water resource that we have in the Western United States and in Wyoming. And it's the basis for the majority of water that we find in our streams. So better understanding how snow accumulation works in forest is one of the key components of better understanding how we can manage water resources moving into the future.
Our forests in the Western United States are natural water towers. They are the key to where our water falls and gets stored and what we rely on for our water source.
So we're currently in south central Wyoming in the beautiful Sierra Madre. When we came in from encampment, and then we crossed the continental divide and are now in the upper Colorado River Basin. And these are some of the headwaters that provide crucial water resources for all the states that the Colorado River runs through. The method of snow measurements that we're doing here is called snowtography. And really what it comes down to is we're taking pictures of graduated stakes that are sticking out of the snow. And when snow accumulates, the camera will keep track of how that changes. And then looking at the pictures, we can derive a snow depth. And that also means that we have a time series of snow depth. Long-term data collection is really the most important kind of data that we have, because that's the only time when we see trends.
Using standardized snowtography practices across the whole Colorado River Basin lets us learn a lot about how different forest types, different elevation zones, how all those things impact how we hold on to snow and if we could potentially hold on to more snow for longer.
We come out here about every 2 weeks and take manual samples with a federal snow sampler, which is essentially just an aluminum tube. This particular site is focused on understanding the effects of thinning.
Forest thinning is really going into a forest, removing certain trees, and there can be a variety of goals associated with that thinning, right? It can be wildfire risk reduction. You could be trying to build a timber stock for future timber sale. You could be trying to improve wildlife habitat or forage.
We're specifically interested in some of the more nuanced differences in terms of canopy density, in terms of species composition. So snowpack under forest canopies is usually not quite as deep as in open areas, but it is more likely to stick around for longer because it is protected from solar radiation.
If we know that our forest manager partners are going to continue to do forest thinning for a variety of goals, the goal of this science is really to provide them with the best up-to-date information on how they could potentially thin the forest in a way that helps optimize those water resource benefits.
Large motivation for my work is to make sure that in the future we still have water resources available. I have kids. I want to make sure that my kids are able to live in Wyoming if they choose to.
The big takeaway that I'm hoping for with this research is that we learn we do have the tools to act proactively, that we can use forest thinning, different approaches to forest restoration to help us bolster our water resources for the future and potentially avoid some of the worst impacts of future drought years.